The city is beautiful. It's wonderful. I mean, and what really, really surprised me were this enormous amount of children that I saw every morning or and during the day going from cinema to cinema. That's amazing. I don't know many festivals. I think this is the only one even that has so many kids. Yeah, ITVA has it, but here it is, but it's so much bigger, ITVA. So this is over 20,000 children visiting the cinemas and get to know about documentaries and get some information. And these, of course, are docs made for children, but they're normally confronted with fiction. And they watch online a lot of the hours per day they spend online or behind the television. So it's very, very good that they learn that there's something else than only cartoons, the only Mickey Mouse and whatever children's shows or so. I would urge the Ministry of Culture here to build a good cinema or whatever. This city deserves it. And you see that there is an audience, and these little kids, that's the audience of the future. And the same is for television. There are a lot of cartoons on television, there are a lot of Disney channels and whatever. I think like 4 or 5 only for children, but I didn't see a single documentary made for kids. And I think that is something that would really benefit the documentary and the documentary community here in Romania to start something like that. It costs money, of course, and it takes time to build it. But the audience is here. The audience is absolutely here. The cinemas are packed. Or cinemas, I should say, theaters or locations, because they are not real cinemas. Holland is not very well known because of its feature films or fiction films. I always say Chekhov is not born in the Netherlands, you know. We are more people who are traveling the world, had our colonies, do trade, speak a lot of languages because we're very small, of course, we need to. And I thought, this is crazy. We have this great documentary tradition with Joris Evens, Herman van der Horst, Bert Haanstra, fantastic filmmakers, but they were only shown now and then in cinemas. And then only like for 2 weeks or 3 weeks, and then poops, it was gone. So I thought, this is crazy. So I just had the idea of starting a documentary film festival. And then the first festival in 1988, we showed around 60 films. We had 2,000 people in the audience, or 2,000 sold tickets, which is not very much, as you can imagine. But we had very, very, very good publicity. And that helped a lot for the second year. So the second year, we already doubled our audience. And the year after, we doubled it again. And it went on like this up till now. I think last year, we sold around 280,000 tickets, which makes it bigger even than the Berlinale, for example, in Berlin. ITVA got the form for co-financing, which was an idea of the commissioning editors. Because these commissioning editors, every week or day, they get like new projects on their desk. But it's a lot of work to all read them, and a forum for co-financing means that all these people come together, and that within 10 minutes you hear about the project of different directors and producers. They have a trailer, they show some of their work, and it's easy. And also you get to meet the producer or director. It's not only a piece of paper, but it's all, you see the faces, you can feel if you will get along with those people. It's also about chemistry. And if you like the film plan and you like the director and producer, and there's a click between the commissioning editors and the other two, then it goes faster, much faster than reading all the projects online or on paper. Don't forget, because it's not cheap to go to a festival. You have to pay for your hotel. Usually when people come from developing countries, we don't let them pay a fee for the accreditation or for watching the films, but still it's expensive. You have to spend a couple of days there, you have to travel, you have to pay for going to the movies. So it helps for a lot of festival programmers, for example, just to see who live wherever in Kenya. They can see the films there online and can make a selection for their own whatever television channel or festival. I think that it's important also to state that during the festival there are over 150 programmers only from festivals there. So when your film is at ITVA or in a Docs for Sale or Docs for Sale online, those festival programmers will probably see your film and invite it for their festival. So it has an enormous spin-off. When you go to ITVA online, you can see the whole selection of the last 30 years. And some films you can still see and you can watch for free. And some of the films you have to pay like $2, which is not a lot of money, but you can see the whole film. And you can see that when the people have to pay, they're not watching. We're very spoiled, of course. Look at YouTube, everything is for free. And so business-wise, it's very, very tough. That's not only for documentaries online, it's also for documentaries in the cinemas, etc. People tend to go to a fiction film rather than to a documentary film. So it is not easy, it's absolutely not easy. But we are, of course, subsidized and sponsored. The ITVA budget is, for example, one third is the city of Amsterdam and the Ministry of Culture from the Netherlands. Second part is the box office, and third is sponsoring. So, and it's a huge budget, but still, it's every year it's difficult to do it. We are lucky with our box office, because that increases 1.5 million, and which is enormous according for documentaries, and only in 10 days. But the rest of the year, I have to admit, when there's a documentary in the cinema, maybe also again 2 or 3 weeks and that's it, and then it stops, and they're not very profitable. Unless your name is Michael Moore, for example, or Al Gore, yeah, that helps. And you know, the thing is, of course, it's not easy, documentaries. Usually it's not that you're laughing like crazy and having a great deal of fun. It's about a lot of problems that we have in this world, whether it's climate change, migration, religion, all these tough subjects, and it can make you cry, it can make you feel very depressed when you see too much. That's also why ITVA always tries to have music films or sport films, because then it's something light in between. On the other hand, I think it's very, very important that there's an exchange of information, that we know about each other, that we learn about different cultures, other religions. As I said before, it's better to watch a movie, a documentary, and to discuss what we just saw. And of course, there are all different points of views. I mean, you don't necessarily have to agree, but as long as you can talk and debate, I think that is the most important. Documentary also creates awareness of problems in this world or problems within certain areas, you know, and I think it's very, very important. Can it change the world? I even think it can, you know, in a way. Changing the world is a big, big thing, but it can change people's ideas about something. Yeah, absolutely. Documentary is very, very powerful in that sense. It's also about educating people and having a good time. I mean, a good documentary, then you also really love the storytelling. The storytelling is so important. And it doesn't necessarily mean that the documentary needs a beginning, middle, or end. It just needs good storytelling. It doesn't necessarily have to be in that order. And everybody loves stories, good stories.